It's in there somewhere. They're not that easy to film, are they? I suppose I should focus on some blossoms and hope that they'll come. Hold still for a minute. They do make a dreadful sound. Going to the gum blossoms, let's wait for it. Now, that's a spiny-cheeked honeyeater. I think it's being chased away by a wattle bird. Let's see. The red wattle birds have been discovering the sugar water too. So, while the spiny-cheeked honeyeaters have been coming, the wattle birds have noticed it finally, I think. I'm not a bird expert. Now, what sort of bird is this? This is a wattle bird, look. It's a wattle bird, a red wattle bird. Look at its little golden bottom. Look at its red wattles. There's its bottom, golden bottom and red wattles. Where are you? So, they're finally chasing the spiny-cheeked honeyeaters away. Where are you, darling? Up high in the cypress tree. Where are you? Oh, you just won't hold still, will you? At least I know where they come now. They sure flit about a lot. It's getting the gum blossom, the nectar. There you are. There you are. Show us your face, you fool. I know where they are now, because they knock all these red gum blossoms off. They do. That's a sign that they're around, I've deduced. So that's handy. And that's what they look like, the gum blossoms. Oops. That's what the gum blossoms look like. And maybe I'll try and hang up some of this on that nectar bottle. But they get around in a group up high in the treetops, and they're very hard to film, I'm finding out this way. So I shall have to try and catch them and get them in an open space. At least I know where they are now. I've heard them up in this tree for days now, but I didn't know what they were doing. I see now what they've been up to. There's its tail. Oops, it's gone now. That's that. So much for that.